Welcome to the 22nd,
22nd, yeah,
episode of, yeah, Gary's English, mm-hmm, Learning Center.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, today we are going to talk about a very, very difficult topic.
And when we say, yeah, we say 22nd, we mean two little ducks. Yeah, two little ducks, you
ducks
know.
Ducks in the row.
Two little ducks. It's, yeah, 22 is like two little ducks. And,
yeah, yeah.
And I've got to ask you, Eddie, really, maybe make it big, yeah?
Yeah.
Make it big. Big it up.
Oh, big. Big, oh, we already had big ducks.
Yeah.
A few months ago, you know, in the Victoria Harbour.
That's right. Yeah.
The yellow duck actually right now is in, as far as I can remember, in Taiwan.
Taiwan, yeah, that's, yeah, right, Taiwan, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So
I'm going to ask you, have you got your ducks in a row?
Ducks in a row. What does it mean?
It means, have you got everything arranged, everything in order, everything ready, you know? Are you ready?
Yeah. Of course, Eddie is ready.
Eddie's, yeah, ready, steady, Eddie. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. But for the Cantonese speakers, of this, who are listening to this show, in Chinese we call it 成语.
成语.
Yeah, idioms.
Right.
Yeah, because in, mm-hmm, in Chinese always have this four characters idiom.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure whether you know it or not.
Well, I learned some, you know, like
Qing
Soi Mou Yu.
Yeah, yeah, Qing Mou Yu.
Yeah, yeah, you know.
Well, actually, in Chinese, if you ask your students, they will have very thick dictionary where, yeah, they can consult.
Yeah, it's really, it's a fundamental part, isn't it?
Yeah, but do you have it?
I don't have that, and no, I just learn them from...
I mean, in English, do you have that kind of dictionary?
No, not really, no.
Not really?
No, we just learn them, we just learn, you know.
And this is why we are doing this show.
Yeah, that's right.
Because you cannot check a dictionary for this,
no,
for the,
no,
meaning.
So this,
of
this is kind of like a video dictionary, really.
Video dictionary, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of them to remember. And we'll just show you some of the
common ones.
Common
ones. So, yeah, if people, yeah, talk to you in idioms, which native people do, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Maybe, boom, boom.
Yeah, and we can go to the PowerPoint, mm-hmm, to let you know how to.
One I learned recently. Just go to that's it. Okay, yeah, yeah.
Ducks in a row, which means that mm-hmm, all the things are okay in order.
Mm-hmm.
And once bitten, twice shy.
Yeah.
This is really very simple, and, yeah, I guess everybody should understand.
That's right. Yeah. If you've done something and you find it's a bad thing one,
yeah,
time,
yeah,
you won't do it again. Or, yeah, if somebody's tricked you once,
yeah,
you won't let them trick you a second time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You try to avoid it.
Yeah.
Out of the frying pan and into the fire.
Mm-hmm.
This is easy to understand.
It is, isn't it? You're in a bad situation, and you think, yeah, you can avoid that, yeah, bad, yeah, situation. You get go to an even worse one.
Yeah, get to the worse one.
Yeah.
Between a rock and a hard place, mm-hmm, well, this is, does it mean that you have a very difficult choice?
Yeah, you between two bad things, really. It's a dilemma. It's a dilemma between two bad things. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
You got a choice of one bad thing, yeah, and another bad thing. What do you do?
Yeah,
and there's a little song, you know.
Yeah,
because you know, idioms are in songs. You know, idioms are in songs.
Again, we have to explain these in more details.
Mm.
The reason why Gary is bringing up these songs is that if you're listening to the lyrics,
mm-hmm,
to the lines in the songs, you will discover many times that they're using a lot of idioms.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, in, yeah, songs. Yeah,
yeah. But the sad thing is that most of the people who are listening to the songs, they do not care about the lyrics.
they don't really. Yeah.
Yeah.
They just kind of listen to a dream kind of thing, but
yeah,
the,
yeah,
lyrics are quite profound sometimes, really meaningful, you know.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
You know.
So my suggestion is that if you want to learn very idiomatic English, which means that you can use a lot of idioms,
which is normal, natural English,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, natural English. Actually. Then you can listen to the lyrics of this classic,
yeah,
rock
by
and
the where's it gone?
This one.
Yeah, that's,
yeah,
the one.
Yeah,
and it's 1 minute and 3 seconds.
Yeah, yeah.
One minute.
Go fast.
No, 1 minute and 3 seconds.
Yeah, yeah.
1 minute and 3 seconds.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So you see, Mick Jagger was singing, between rock and
a hard place. Yeah.
Just listen to that very, very small,
yeah,
segment.
And that's the name of the song if you want to catch it.
Yeah,
you know,
sure.
Yourselves, yeah.
Yeah, that is the perfect way to learn your, mm-hmm, idioms. So we get to the next one.
It was too many cooks, sorry.
Too many cooks spoil the broth.
Yeah, sometimes you think it might be good to have a big team doing a job, but yeah. Sometimes they can get on each other's toes, you know.
And create a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
And in Cantonese, we say, what should we say in Cantonese? In the opposite is that 人多好辦事, but in the opposite we say the 人多手腳亂. Yeah, I remember.
I'm gonna watch this show, right, and learn some more.
Remember, you have to do that. You, Gary, will have to do the subtitles. I was wondering whether he can type all this Chinese.
Oh my god!
Or not? What you gain on the swings, you lose on the roundabouts.
Yeah.
What does it mean?
You gain on the swings, you lose on the roundabouts. You might have a situation where you're actually benefiting in something, yeah, but you lose as well, you know?
Yeah,
you win and you lose in the same time,
A stitch in time saves nine.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Yeah, it means you repair something before it breaks down completely, you know?
未雨綢繆, 未雨綢繆. Don't put all your eggs in one basket.
Mm-hmm.
Again, this is very intelligent advice on investment.
That's right, yeah.
A bird in the hand is worth two in the bush.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, this is true.
Yeah. You stick with what you've got, you know. Don't try and get something that you think might be better, you know. Yeah. Appreciate what you have. You know?
Yeah. It's a walk in the park.
It's easy.
A piece of cake.
Yeah, a piece of cake, yeah. Or it's a breeze, yeah.
Yeah. The elephant in the room.
Mm.
Do we have elephant here?
It means there's a big problem that I know about and you know about.
But you don't want to admit it.
We pretend it's not there.
The other man's grass is always greener. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's right. Yeah,
yeah.
There's a Chinese idiom for that, isn't there? I think there is.
About
the moon. Something about the moon. Yeah. The moon is brighter.
外國嘅月亮特別光。
Yeah.
外來的和尚特別會念經。會念經。Over the hill.
Means you're too old.
Too old. Oh yeah, I'm over the hill.
Over the hill. Yeah.
For boxing.
Too old. Yeah. No, I wouldn't say that. Having watched you, I wouldn't.
Mm.
I wouldn't. There's still life in the old dog yet.
Yeah. A red herring.
You know, when you watch a detective story,
yeah.
You know, they say, oh, it's, or you read a book, you know, they say, it's that person.
Mm.
But actually it's not. There's a clue that makes you think it's that person, but actually it's a false clue. A red herring is a false clue.
A simple way of putting it is some kind of misleading clues.
Yeah, a false misleading
something
clue,
something that mislead you to the wrong direction.
Yeah. One conclusion, even.
Yeah. Something smells fishy.
Mm. There's something suspicious.
Yeah, suspicious.
Makes you feel suspicious.
But why do the bitches think that fishy is bad?
Well, have you smelled rotten fish?
Rotten fish.
I have. Yeah.
Yeah, that
smells terrible. Yeah.
Yeah. Plenty more fish in the sea.
Mm-hmm. Means there's more opportunities out there. Don't think you have no more chance. There's more opportunities.
Yeah. Deep pockets.
Mm. I got very shallow pockets. Means rich pockets.
Which means that you have a lot of resources and money.
But let's not forget, I learned a new Chinese idiom. Is it Yao Fuk Mo Meng Heng?
Oh, yeah. Really?
Yeah, Yao Fuk Mo Meng Heng, my latest Kenyan. Yeah. But for me, it's Mo Fuk Yao Meng Heng.
Okay. Diamond on the soles of her shoes.
Yeah. Means she's a rich girl.
Do we have
we have a little video here.
Yeah.
Paul Simon. This 25 seconds.
Yeah,
this one.
Yeah, this one. So we can listen it from the beginning because it's not too long. Okay. This is very simple, which means that some people are very rich.
Rich, yeah. Diamonds on the soles of her shoes. Yeah. Yeah.
You're so rich that you can put on the diamonds.
Yeah, and she'll never go barefoot, you see. Barefoot means she'll always have shoes, right? She'll always be rich, you know.
There's a hole in my shoe. Literally, there's actually a hole in my shoe.
Which is the opposite, right? A hole in my shoe means you're poor, you know.
Poor.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We do have that one,
We have. Have we got that one?
Yeah, we got the hole in my shoe.
Where's that?
This one here.
This one there.
Yep. Hold me in my shoe. 28 seconds. 28 seconds. You go on a bit.
We don't mess with that because of...
Back to the 60s, huh?
Well, so you see, actually, you can sing the whole idioms out.
And that helps to remember it.
Hell yeah, it helps. It helps.
Really helps. Right?
Yeah. So, something fishy one. And the next one. A fish out of water.
Yeah.
Well, the question is, why there's so many fish?
Because Britain, you know, like Japan, it's an island, isn't it? It's surrounded by sea, seafaring, seafaring nation.
A lot of expression have something to do with fish.
And we go out to sea, and we and there's English people all over the world, you know, like me. You know,
a fish on the sand.
Yep.
I guess it's something like the fish out of water.
The same thing, and the fish on a bicycle, where you shouldn't be, you know. Yeah,
fish on the bicycle. Yeah. Which is a very surreal situation.
Yeah, that's a surreal, one, yeah.
It's water off a duck's back. Mm-hmm. A duck's back.
Means that it something won't affect you. Because a duck has oil in its...
You see, we have exactly the same expression in Canada,
really?
In Chinese. Exactly the same. But it means that something that you forgot easily.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, something won't affect you, yeah.
Oh, it's different.
Different, yeah.
It's different. It means that the student is not very attentive to the study.
Oh, it's a bit of a different meaning, yeah?
Yeah.
It means in this case, it means you're not too sensitive, you know?
Yeah, so my advice is that you actually have to check the English dictionary to make sure that you don't take the whole meaning by guessing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, you can't get this from a dictionary, that's the thing, you know?
Every cloud has a silver lining.
Yeah.
This is easy.
Yeah, and even if there's a problem, there's usually something good you know, come out of a problematic situation, you know.
Like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Yeah, which means it's a very hard to find, you know.
Of course.
Very hard to find, but it's a lovely song, you know.
It's a song.
We missed out Fish on the Sand, but okay.
No, we should go back to the fishing on the
Fish on the Sand.
Because I'm just...
Okay, let's 50 seconds. Let's go 50 seconds. 50. I'm sorry. Back to Fish on the Sand.
Fish on the Sand.
So he's saying without his love, he's like a fish on the sand. So what's going to happen to a fish on the sand?
Yeah. It means that it is the end of your life.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's very romantic. Yeah.
And talking about George Harrison, the last time we mentioned the British icon, Gary forget a essential British icon of the century.
The Beatles. Maybe that's true.
So we got now we come to the needle in the haystack.
It's too good, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's too good. You can stop watching.
Yeah. Because the first time I was actually watching the video because of the very beautiful image, and I forgot the lyrics.
There were go-go.
So you see the problem is that when an image is so beautiful and so cute.
Yeah.
I was about to say erotic. But
really?
No. It is actually my personal projection. So if you are looking at something very interesting, then you forget.
Yeah.
They were
called go-go dancers in those days. Go-go dancers.
Don't mention it. The young people will be very bored.
Okay. And it was Tamla Motown anyway.
Yeah, Motown. Yeah.
Right, great.
But anyway. The girls are...
And they were singing Needle in the Haystack, you know?
Needle in the Haystack.
Like, like looking for a needle in a haystack. Yeah. It's hard to find as a needle in a haystack. Something difficult to find. And a good man is like finding a needle in a haystack.
Yeah. Actually, I find it difficult to remember that. I didn't listen to the lyrics.
It's a good job I'm here, isn't it, really? Yeah. You know, it's a good thing I'm here, really.
So
keep the show on track. You know?
Keep the show on track. Yeah. Okay. The last straw that broke the camel's back.
This is kind of a biblical thing, yeah? You know, you suffer this and you suffer that, and there's just one too many things, and it just breaks
you. You say, I'm fed up, and I can't go on.
That's enough, too much.
That's enough, okay. Throw the towel in.
Mm. As we said in the previous show, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, throw the towel in and you give up.
That's a boxing metaphor.
Yep, that's right, a boxing metaphor, yeah.
Yeah. Like a bow in a China shop.
Yep.
If there is a bow in a China shop, what happens?
Yeah, you mean you're so aggressive and you just don't care about inconsiderate kind of person.
You broke everything.
Yeah.
And everything expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that is valuable in the place.
That's right.
Yeah. Pie in the sky.
Pie in the sky is you have a dream or a dream about something, but really you can't really realise that dream. Yeah.
Something that is
unachievable.
Unachievable.
Yeah, really, yeah.
Over the moon.
Over the moon. Means you're really, really happy.
Happy.
Yeah, I was over the moon to see you today.
But why is over the moon?
it's as high as you can go.
Oh, yeah.
As high as you can be.
So does it have something to the similar, like the song that is very, very popular in the 50s, Fly Me to the Moon.
Fly me to the moon and
does
take
it
me.
Means
yeah, the, yeah, that's a nice song. Yeah. And maybe from the nursery rhyme, the cow jumped over the moon. That's a lovely song. Yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
Flogging a dead horse.
Yeah. Mean something, somebody's already tired out and you try and make them do more, you know. So you can say that to your boss if he tries to make you do too much work. You say, you're flogging a dead horse, you know, because I've been working overtime all week.
Yeah.
I can't do any more, you know.
Another one is a very famous title of 60s.
Yeah. Which is the same 60s. Meaning, yeah.
They shoot horses, don't they?
Yeah.
What does it mean?
It's the same meaning, really.
Same meaning?
Yeah, somebody's really, really tired, you know, and I can't do any more, you know.
But why? What has it to do with horse shooting?
Well, because when a horse is almost dead, right? They will shoot it before it's dead, you know, when it's no more use, you know.
Or actually, that it happened.
Yeah. And then they take it to the knacker's yard. It's called. And they use it for dog food.
Yeah.
If you really want to know. Yeah.
You take a horse to the water, but you can't make it drink. Yep. In Chinese, we have the same expression, but you use the cow as a subject instead of horse.
Yeah. Maybe that.
But
comes from
I think it makes more sense to use a cow as a subject.
But you can teach a student, but you can't make them learn, you know.
No, that's
from a teacher's point of view, anyway. Right?
I got it from the horse mouth.
We have covered this before in previous shows. Yeah, you get it from the original source. Yeah.
Why horses couldn't drag me away?
Yep.
No, I don't get it.
Yeah, it means, you know, I mean, this is kind of like a love thing, really. You know, something you really, really like. Mm. Yeah? You can't be stopped liking that thing, you know. Yeah. We've got cue for another song, Eddie.
Yeah, really?
Cue for another song, yeah.
Which one?
Yep.
This one? I forgot.
And it's 1 minute 20 seconds.
So
1 minute 20.
Fast.
120.
Yeah.
120, a little bit further, I think. Yeah. A little bit further is good. Yeah. Quite a famous song, yeah?
Yeah. You know how I am.
Even wild horses, something really strong, can't take you away from the thing you really like.
Again, you see, Mick Jagger said, why horses can't drag me away from your love.
That's right, from your love. Or something you love, you know.
Yeah.
Especially your love, yeah.
So remember next time when you try to please your girlfriend, you say something like this.
Yeah, wild horses couldn't drag me away from you, darling.
Which, of course, you don't mean what you say. To open a can of worms.
Was that one? You missed one.
Did I miss something?
Yeah. Oh yeah, you missed. Yeah, sorry, is it too many? Yeah, this one's right. This one isn't. Yeah, sorry, this one. It's not rocket science. Yeah,
it's not something that is very very difficult because of rocket science is something very advanced.
It's quite a new one. This one.
Yeah, new one. Yeah. You have to use a lot of mathematics.
Yep.
Make hay while sun shines.
Yep.
And be prepared.
Yeah, do it while you can. This is do it while you can. Yeah.
Or do it while you can.
Do it while you can.
Be timely.
Yeah. If you have the opportunity, grab it. Yeah.
Grab it.
My Jiao Gai.
Are we on the same page? Mm-hmm. Are we on the same bandwidth?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, on the same bandwidth. Yeah, this is an American one. You know, I sort of slipped that one in.
Yeah, let sleeping dogs lie.
Yeah.
Just leave them alone.
Yeah, leave it alone. Yeah, leave it alone. Yeah, leave it alone. If there's a problem, turn a blind eye. We also say if you don't need to see that problem, then don't. No.
Don't rock the boat.
Yeah.
But for this one, actually, there's a very famous disco song in the 70s, Rock the Boat.
The Boat,
which you forgot.
I got, you know. If we have everything, we make the show too long again, you know.
Total
Rock the Boat, baby,
Total line. Don't create trouble.
And both of these mean to conform, you know, with the current situation.
Really?
Toe the line really means to conform. These are actually like Freemason things, these ones,
Why don't you say some more thing about it.
Don't rock the boat, toe the line, it means you
draw the line,
you draw your place.
Yeah,
toe the line, you know. The tie that binds is another one.
Oh.
The tie, you know, people wear a tie,
it actually
represents the, like a dog being tied to a stake.
Yeah.
Really.
Okay.
Yeah. And you call a spade a spade, isn't it?
No, not yet. To open a can of worms.
A can of worms, yeah.
Yeah, to get into something that is very troublesome.
Yeah, reveal something that's been going on. Yeah, that's really bad. Yeah,
everybody else is not going to like it.
Yeah, and the same with the cat out of the bag.
Yeah.
There's a secret that people have been trying to keep.
Yeah,
you reveal the secret. Let the cat out of the bag. A bad secret.
Yeah. He's on the soapbox.
Yeah, there he is. He's talking about his favorite subject again.
Does this have something to do with the Hyde Park?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, very good. Yeah. And people used to, you know. They wanted to talk about it in Hyde Park. That's correct. Yeah.
Once in a blue moon.
Yeah, we got another song here, but we just go to the end here. Once in a blue moon means rarely. Yeah, it doesn't happen very often once in a blue moon.
A spade at that.
Somebody who's really not all there, you know.
One yao tai hui. Which means that your soul goes to the space.
Something like that.
This is easy to answer.
Yeah.
A house of cards.
Something that is a fragile structure, yeah.
Something like Castle on the Sand?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Castles in the Air, yeah.
In the Air.
Yeah.
So what song have you got?
We had the, what was it? Blue Moon, yeah.
Oh, this one. You should listen to this one.
So it was a rare chance to meet his lover, really, yeah?
Yeah.
You saw me standing alone.
Actually, I want to listen to the whole song, but you see, there might be some copyright issue about that. So you go to check it out yourself.
Music's a beautiful thing, isn't it?
I like this song very much.
Yeah, Chris Isaacs, he's got a lovely sound, isn't he?
Yeah.
And
so what else have we got?
Call a spade a spade. Yeah, say what you mean. You remember from the last show?
Say what you mean, mean what you say. There's a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow.
Which is similar to the pie in the sky, you know, really, yeah? Because there's no end to the rainbow, so you'll never find that pot of gold, right?
It means that you will never find.
Something you can never realize, right?
Oh, yeah. Too sad. Yeah. Out to lunch.
Is the same as the space cadet again, you know?
Now, this is some very, very tricky issue in English. Actually, I guess 99% of the Cantonese speakers was take it literally.
Yeah. Of course,
Yeah. You're out at lunch.
Yeah.
And when somebody... When somebody, some native English speakers use that, most of the people here will take it as that guy really get to out at lunch.
Yeah.
On a wild goose chase.
Yeah, which means
something to you devote a lot of time and effort, but has no hope of getting results.
That's right. That's perfect. Yeah.
You always take the weather with you.
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean?
It means if you're in a bad mood and you don't lose that bad mood, you know, even somebody has made you in a bad mood, right?
Yeah.
But then you go and see somebody else,
yeah,
and you take that bad mood to the other person, right?
Yeah. So, have we got any song?
We have. We've got a song here by a great New Zealand band called Crowded House.
Yeah.
It's 1 minute and 10 seconds. That's it. Makes you want to pick up.
Everywhere you go, always take the weather with you. Everywhere you go,
always take the weather with you. I have to admit, this is a song that I've missed. This is a very famous band, New Zealand band in the 80s, and they got one very popular hit song, but this one I missed. For I didn't realize that they have such a great song until you.
Yeah, well, I only heard it when I was actually in New Zealand. Yeah.
It's one that
I missed actually before. Yeah.
Yeah.
I went to New Zealand about 10 years ago, and I heard.
Yeah.
They played it on the radio. And
Wow!
What a great riff that is.
Yeah. Again, you should check it out if you have time. So the last one that we have is The Boy Who Cried Wolf, Long Lai Liu.
Long Lai Liu,
yeah.
And I think about the observatory always telling us that the typhoon is going to hit us every time we put everything indoors and take the window.
The last time that we had is not actually wolf, it is a rabbit.
Yeah, that's right, it's a rabbit. It was Sagi, the rabbit.
It was a rabbit.
Yeah.
It was a rabbit. So we have spent a lot of time, more than the usual time of our show for idioms. So you see, the point is that there are a lot of them to remember.
And that's enough for one day. It went for one show, isn't it? Really, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
These are the common ones. So if somebody says something like this to you, at least you won't go,
or
take it the wrong way.
So why don't we call it a day?
We should call it a day.
Yeah, sure.
We'll call it a day. Yeah.
Yeah, sure. See you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.